The Colorado River is under pressure. Lake Mead is staying in shortage. A billion-dollar data center deal in Tucson just collapsed. And California homes are literally sinking in value because the ground beneath them is dropping. This week's water stories show just how much is at stake for our future. Let's dive in.
Welcome back to Western Water Weekly, your source for water news across the Colorado River Basin. Here's what happened this week, August 11th through August 16th, 2025. Utah's Division of Water Resources is launching a series of community water talks to shape the state's 2026 water plan. These meetings will run from late August through October in towns from Monticello to Salt Lake City. The plan will look at current water use, future demand, and strategies to protect and manage supplies. Residents can weigh in on priorities for agriculture, cities, recreation, and conservation. Utah law requires a plan every 10 years. But the state now aims for updates every 5 years. In Arizona, Tucson's city council voted unanimously to stop negotiations on Project Blue, a $3.6 billion plan for a massive data center campus. Supporters promised jobs, tax revenue, and new infrastructure, including a reclaimed water pipeline and recharge facility. But critics raised concerns about transparency, water use, and energy demand. In the end, city leaders pulled the plug and also began drafting new rules for large water users and future data centers. In California, Pacific Gas and Electric has officially filed its plan to surrender the Potter Valley Project license and remove both Cape Horn Dam and Scott Dam. These dams block salmon and steelhead from historic habitat in the Eel River. Their removal would restore access for fish but also end hydropower at the site. A new facility is proposed to keep some water moving into the Russian River for agriculture and communities. The project has been in operation for more than a century, and public comment on decommissioning is now open. Nevada has launched a voluntary program allowing farmers and ranchers to sell their groundwater rights to the state. Once purchased, the rights are permanently retired to help stabilize aquifers. Groundwater provides more than 80% of the supply in half of Nevada's counties, and long-term declines threaten springs, wetlands, and communities. The Nature Conservancy says success will depend on securing steady funding and focusing on overdrawn aquifers and sensitive ecosystems. Arizona State University's Kyle Center for Water Policy has released a plain language explainer on what happens when the 2007 Colorado River operating guidelines expire at the end of 2025. Those rules set shortage tiers and helped stabilize Lake Mead. But if no new plan is in place, Arizona could face even deeper cuts, especially to Central Arizona Project water. Lower priority users in Mojave, La Paz, and Yuma counties could also be hit. Federal and state officials are racing to reach a new agreement for 2026. A study from the University of California Riverside shows that land subsidence, which is the sinking of ground from groundwater pumping, has cost Central Valley homeowners nearly $2 billion in lost property value between 2015 and 2021. Homes in sinking areas sold for up to 5.8% less than similar properties elsewhere. Researchers say this hidden cost of overpumping hurts families' ability to build equity and underscores the urgency of managing groundwater under California's sustainability law. The Bureau of Reclamation released its August projections for Lake Powell and Lake Mead. Lake Powell is expected to remain in the mid-elevation release tier in 2026, with 7.48 million acre-feet of water released downstream. Lake Mead, however, will stay in shortage, meaning that cutbacks of more than 500,000 acre-feet for Arizona, 21,000 acre-feet for Nevada, and 80,000 acre-feet for Mexico will remain in place. Federal officials say the numbers highlight the urgent need for a new seven-state agreement by 2026. The U.S. Drought Monitor shows worsening drought across much of the country, including the Colorado River Basin. Northwestern Colorado has slipped into exceptional drought, the most severe category. Nearly 1 in 5 corn acres in northwestern Colorado is now rated poor or very poor. Utah's rangelands are suffering, with almost half in poor condition. Arizona's weak monsoon has failed to bring relief. Nevada and California remain very dry, and forecasts show little chance of major improvement through late August. That wraps up this week's water news. For links to the full reports and daily updates, be sure to visit western-water.com. Thanks for watching Western Water Weekly. Subscribe, stay informed, and we'll see you next time.